What's up? It's me. Coming at you this time with a video blog. Some things that's been on my heart that I want to get out. First of all, problems. Problems come. Problems come. Just get over it. You gotta accept the fact that you're not too good to get a problem. And you gotta accept the fact, this is the tricky part, that what you may have done in the past may not actually be the catalyst for your problems. As in, God really doesn't punish us to the full extent compared to what we really did. Like if he really punished us to the full extent, we'd be dead. Anyway, now what does happen, consequence for your actions. That's, you know, kind of law of the land. But the real deal that I'm coming to you today about is the problems that seem to be a little out of order. The problems that come and hit your whole family. The problems that come that hit every aspect of your life. The problem that comes that kind of leaves you powerless. The kind of problems that leave you without options. The kind of problems that, you know, kind of bring you to depression. The kind of problems that keep your mind going when you're supposed to be at, you know, sleep. Those kind of problems are not really problems. They're what you call an attack. You have a satanic attack on your life. Be happy. I know it's weird. I know it's different. But be happy. Those things come, they are indications that your life is worth something. They're not the only indication that your life is worth something, but they're an indication that you're on the move. They're an indication that who you are is so dangerous that you must be stopped. That being said, don't be a punk. You got power. You got blessings. You got energy. You got God. When God's inside of you, when he's working through your life, you win every time. So these kind of problems are, you know, indications that you're on the right path. Don't be discouraged. It's alright to be sad. It's alright to be angry. Every emotion we feel is valid. The issue is when we wallow and we don't move. You can stay in the cave, but you got to come out the cave after a while. Here's the other thing, and this is the part that may be a little difficult. If anybody is to blame for what's going on in your life, it's either you or God. I know some of y'all about to go crazy with comments, but let me explain. God is the creator. Everything that he ever did, he did through his creation. He even created Satan. Point number two. God is all-knowing. So if he created Satan, and he's all-knowing, he knows the end from the beginning, then he's not surprised by what's going on in your life. Point number three. Some of your Bible readers will know this. Satan has to get permission to come to your doorstep. Who gives him that permission? God. Point number four. Never, ever assume that Satan has equal power with God, ever. It just cannot be. It's like me creating a program, a software program, and then the software program thinking it's equal with me. When at the end of the day, I can just delete it. Same thing with God. So, if we put two and two together, here's what we get. All things work together for the good of them who love the Lord and are called according to his purpose. Good stuff, bad stuff, all orchestrated not to bring you down, but to push you through, to make you move, to keep you from being stagnant. God's got a plan. I don't know what it is for you. I'm trying to piece together what it is for me. But either way it goes, something's up. Last thing, God is a God of balance. Every bad day has to be balanced with a good day. So I've been going through a lot of stuff recently. Just realized that, hey, however long you've been suffering, that's how long you're going to be in overflow. Be encouraged. Your life is not pointless. Your life is not worthless. There is people, or there is someone, I wish I could speak English, who loves you. I love you. God loves you. What you need? I hope you love you. Alright, peace and blessings, y'all. Oh yeah, check out the website, promisetoprogress.com. Peruse, look around. Peace.